good to meet you. How are you?
What? We are peeing.
So I got you from Instagram. I saw you have lots of followers. You must be a really good stylist then.
I love fashion. Fashion's something I do love. Although I do a lot more than styling. In fact, I'm a TV personality.
Are you a normal Zamombata?
Not quite. From the same city, Durban.
Okay. Finally got it. Right. It's amazing to see you. Okay, so we brought you here because I need styling tips.
Sure.
I want to connect to your Buntus.
Yes, okay.
And I've seen you have a lot of travel in your look.
Sure.
Today is very different, very European, very chic, very surprising. Style me as if you were going on a date with your husband.
Yes.
See him, I know.
Okay.
Black Coffee. He is an amazing DJ. I was in Ibiza last year. Just a tanning holiday. Sometimes I just go, you know, soak some sun, get some colour. And I heard him play and I was like, oh my God. You know, I don't like house music because it's a bit aggressively black, but he has a spin that just transcends race. He's almost the Tata of music.
Sure. My husband is Zegs, and he's, I don't think you'd like him because he has a song called Ghetto.
See these black famous celebrities. He's not in my radar, my love.
Of course he's not.
Maybe I can get an afro wig to put on top of my hair. It's gonna be so funny. Just some curls.
Or you could take off your wig.
Well, I can't. It's not a wig. It's my natural hair. This is some of the stuff I've gotten. Blue, because obviously the party. I assume you support them.
Not really.
Why are you not voting? I mean, I'm not saying I support the DA. I can't say who I support.
Yeah.
But why are you not going to vote for them?
I just generally don't relate with the DA.
You're rich. You're really pretty and you're light-skinned. And you're blonde. So how do you not...
Well, just because they're not doing stuff for everyone. You can see Khayelitsha, you saw with what's happening in Alexandra.
Where Zaki's from.
Yes. Well, he's from KwaMashu, but same thing. Yeah, absolutely.
Well, we're inclusive of the suburbs. Nandi, you know you live on the line of caucus now.
I mean, that Alexandra's Sandton situation is not ideal. Like, you talk about the caucus.
It's not ideal that Alex is in Sandton. You're right. Anyway, so, wow.
Wow. Yeah, wow.
So what are the hot button issues that like affect a cool girl like Nandi?
So a girl like Nandi.
Oh.
Nandi. You can call me Nans for you. Nans. Okay. Nandi's a bit harsh.
Yeah. It's
the D part.
I can't pronounce the click.
Yeah. Because there is a click. So they say Nans.
Nans.
For someone like me, definitely just the fact that people of color haven't had an apology. We could just start there. So if you.
Well, sorry.
Okay.
Okay, so this is the first thing I have. It looks kind of like jail-esque, kind of maid-esque.
So you're on the edge, liberation struggle of your own for your own people.
Winnie Mandela,
Grassa
Michelle, Helen Zilla, you know, struggle icons. Also, you know what? I'm actually taking a trip to Durban next week, and I know that's where you're from.
Yes.
Now that Mango Sutu is retiring,
yes,
we're gonna need to capture their vote because you guys are no longer gonna vote IFP.
Yes. So Mandi Makaya, the rural people,
all the ghetto people,
the ghetto,
you know, as Ricky Rick said, KwaMashu. What a funny name. And then I've seen helpers wear this a lot. So I want to kind of be like helper off duty. Very
cool.
So
it's a helper off duty look. Okay.
Yes.
All right.
And then this.
So this is not patronizing. It doesn't insult anyone. It's not.
That I'm aware of. No.
No.
And then this is my sort of Safari Town forced removals chic. I think it's a very important look.
Do you think people want to revisit that kind of look?
I think they need to. Mm-hmm. And then I've got this sort of slave chic look that I want to wear. Sort of cotton farmer, cotton picking, wade in the water, struggle. You know, look. I think that's going to connect with them very much. Sure. Okay. And then. I know you guys like bright colours. I've seen the eyes. The eyes of an isiZulu, they're closer together because they need to hunt. And they like brighter colours. So this is something that I'm going to wear just to get their attention. isiZulu warriors. And then, that's about it. How do I look? And then the African beads from Sisi's daughter. I just think this is going to connect with them, really, because it looks like a Sisi's outfit. My Sisi and my girl wears this when she cleans.
No. It's actually quite ugly.
Change next outfit.
This is look number two. I kind of went with like a bit of a safari theme. You know, the Zulus like to hunt and be in the wild, in the bush. So I thought like a little bit of a kimono for the Indian culture of Durban, and then the safari leopard for the isiZulu, because I know they like a lot of leopard print.
Even the people in the rural areas won't relate to this. It's just really busy and it's not really their thing.
How is this worse than the first one, Nandi? I think at this point you just want to be controversial. You want to be the Simon of outfits, and I'm not really enjoying what I'm getting from you. I'm gonna try one more, and it's the last one. I really do think it is the one, but if it doesn't work for you, then you're gonna have to not work for me. Okay. Okay, this is look number three, the isiShweShwe print of the Zulu tribe. Very Zulu, and it's something that I don't really like it that much. It doesn't feel natural. But it's still cute, it's still a peplum, worked in a bit of a denim jacket. And then your tuku, that you people love so much.
Itugu.
And of course, a lovely heel with some pearls.
The shwe shwe vibes, yeah, you're gonna do well in KZN because that's all you need. You don't need to be able to relate to them, speak to them, you know, just an outfit.
Vote for us. Okay, cool.
I've got stuff to do, all the best.
Oh, okay. Bye. You know, people keep saying to me, Kelz, you're black. And I'm only as black as I feel, which is 0%. I'm white on the inside, I'm privileged on the inside, and I'm doing things to make sure it reflects on the outside. So Nandi, please, and everybody else, transracialism is real. Ask Rachel Dolezal.